In this video, we are going to talk about 10 unique ways to develop strong personality. Before we have a tendency to begin, why don't you hit the subscribe button and the bell notification icon so that you never miss any of our videos. Wondering about how to develop a strong personality? You've come to the right place. We can't help the personality we are born with. If you are a naturally shy person or tend to be on the sensitive side, these traits will likely follow you all through your life. In this video, we will discover 10 ways to develop a strong personality. Mentioning the term, strong personality, brings many thoughts to life. People look at this differently, both positive and negative. For example, the negative thoughts about having a strong personality are that you are high-minded, demanding, arrogant, and dominant. While the positive thoughts differ far from the above, a person with a strong personality is one who has strong self-confidence, is a capable leader, can shape his own personality, which means that the person is not influenced by others. A person with a strong personality is determined, who believes in their rights and stands for them, and has good self-discipline. Although there are some traits of your personality which you can't change. However, you can still develop a strong personality characteristic by following some rules. So, here are 10 ways to develop a strong personality that any person can develop. Yes, even if you're an introvert. 10. The ability to set personal boundaries. Most of us want to please our friends, family, and co-workers. Taking on that extra project, taking the kids to their favorite activities, and helping your friends are all part of life. Unfortunately, this can sometimes backfire if you don't know how to say no. It is considered as one of the signs of weak personality traits. If people ask you to do things you find stressful and uncomfortable, the power to refuse becomes critical to your well-being. Sometimes, being there for yourself is just as important as being there for others. If you want to have a strong personality, then you need the ability to set personal boundaries. 9. A sense of self-esteem. Self-esteem is one of the most neglected parts of almost everyone's personality. We are taught from an early age to be humble, not to show off, and to not gloat over our wins. Most of the time this is good. Too much self-esteem can lead to an entitled brat no one can stand to be around. On the other hand, not enough can lead to low self-esteem, depression, tolerating a toxic relationship, and a lack of drive. All those signs lead to you having a weak personality trait. You need a sense of self-esteem in order to have the confidence to reach for your goals. Luckily, anyone can develop self-esteem in a different way, such as traveling or studying abroad. 8. Optimism. A strong personality meaning that you have the mind for optimism. Life can throw us curveballs on a regular basis. Sometimes, the future you want is out of reach because of them. Other times, it's out of reach only because we fear life's problems will crop up just as we try to make a change. Without a sense of optimism, you'll never apply for that dream job, or ask out the coworker you greatly admire. Optimism is an important personality trait, and one well worth fostering. 7. The ability to hold yourself accountable. Being accountable for our own action also represents a strong personality characteristic of a person. When a mistake happens, it's very common for people to scramble about looking for someone else to blame. No one wants to be the one that accidentally allowed a virus onto a company computer, broke an expensive wine glass, or failed to meet a deadline. Yet taking responsibility for our actions is critical to being able to improve. Without acknowledging that a mistake has been made and that we made it, we are digging ourselves into a rut we will never be able to climb out of. 6. A solid work ethic. Studies show that as much as 5 hours of the average employee's work week are spent slacking off. At home, when it comes down to getting the chores done, or even working on the next great American novel, slacking off is still pretty common. Yet a solid work ethic can change that. If you're able to stay on task and get things done, the book will get written, your chores are done in time for a long weekend at the beach, and your productivity at work will increase. Also, you need to be positive regarding your work life, as being positive can increase productivity in the workplace. 5. Emotional intelligence. Yes, you read it right. You need emotional intelligence to have a strong personality. Some people are born knowing what others are thinking, even if they aren't saying anything at all. Paying attention to the behavior and feelings of others, and being able to understand those emotions deeply, is an art few completely master. Anyone, however, can develop this basic sense of how others feel. When you have a greater sense of their feelings, you are better able to handle relationships, a necessary part of living. 4. Charisma. Some people walk into a room and instantly catch the attention of everyone around them. They give off an aura of confidence that makes simply being around them dynamic and engaging. Charisma is a mixture of many of the personality traits we have mentioned earlier, in particular, self-esteem and emotional intelligence. If you care about yourself, and others too, charisma will frequently follow. 3. Self-control. Self-control is the ability to control and alter responses in order to avoid unwanted reactions, increase desirable ones, and achieve long-term goals. Those who are self-controlled can temper what they want, to ensure that they do not over or underindulge. If you want to develop a strong personality, then having self-control is a must. When diet time comes around, or it is time to quit a bad habit, many of us discover how weak our sense of self-control actually is. While fighting your own biology is a pretty advanced task for anyone, developing a sense of self-control doesn't have to be that difficult. By breaking up a task into smaller goals and achieving those ones by one, anyone can learn self-control. 2. Efficiency. Most of us get through life willy-nilly and waste a lot of time trying to complete tasks without any sort of organization. An unorganized life is one of the major obstacles to success which a person needs to avoid for developing a strong personality. Some people are naturally more organized than others, but if a sloppy person can learn even a degree of organization, they can speed up their processes and achieve goals much faster. A little research on how to pay off debts swiftly can save months of interest, and if you invest your long-term savings instead of keeping it in a cash account, you'll gain far more. Learning the most efficient method of doing anything can save time and money, which ultimately helps you to build a strong personality. 1. Discipline. All the well-known people who have a strong personality are highly disciplined people. Self-discipline is so hard to develop, it practically falls under a superpower. Yet doing so can yield dividends in almost every other aspect of your life. While becoming a master of self-discipline can take years, the beginning steps are easy. Simply knowing what tempts you and avoiding them is a great start. Forgiving yourself for an error and continuing to try rather than simply giving up is another huge start. Nearly everyone fails initially when starting a new habit or changing to a healthy lifestyle. Getting up and trying again is what makes the biggest difference. All of these traits for a strong personality are ones that anyone can master. Whether you are an introvert or an extrovert, you can add these to and augment your personality. You don't have to change personality to improve yourself, only augment what is already there. If you want to achieve your goals and do better at life, adding one of these personality traits may be well worth your time. What do you think of our list? Which of the above things shocked you the most? Let me know in the comment section below. If you enjoyed this video and want to hear from me again, be sure to hit that subscribe button before you go. Thanks for watching.